friends, in this video, now we will learn about the boundary conditions. Okay, so in the finite elements method, after the global stiffness matrix, we have to make the finite element formations. That is K U is equal to F. So this is the formulation of finite element equation, where K it will be the stiffness matrix, U is the displacement vector, and F it is an force vector. Okay, so where K it will be global stiffness matrix, and U will be the displacement vector, and F will be the force vector. So once you make the formation of the finite elements equation, then you need to apply the boundary conditions after the formation. So these are the boundary conditions. So now how you will identify the boundary conditions? Okay, so based on the geometry and the case studies, you have to apply the boundary condition. So boundary condition is nothing but it is an input value. Okay, suppose let me take one bar element. There is an bar element and it is a stepped bar, and let us apply the node at the middle of the bar where the cross section is changed. Okay, so now I will denote this is 1, 2, 3. Okay, so again, this is a first case. So now here the force, it will be suppose 10 kilo Newton. The force is applied will be 10 kilo Newtons. Now based on this problem, how you will calculate the boundary conditions? Okay, so as per the boundary conditions, when it is fixed, okay, when the element is fixed, then the displacement at their ends we will take as zero. Now at the node 1, so node 1, node 2, node 3, so node 1 displacement it will be u1, and displacement at 2 it will be u2, displacement at 3 it will be u3. Now as we said, when there is a fixed end, the displacement it will be zero. So I have to say u1 is equal to zero. This is the first boundary condition. Whenever there is a fixed end, then the displacement it will be zero. Suppose if I made this is end also zero, means another end is also fixed. So if this is becomes fixed, then u3 also becomes zero. Okay, so there u3 also becomes zero if both the ends are fixed. Okay, now I will remove the fixed end. Now only u1 will be zero. So that is the first boundary condition. Now second, okay, so in the displacement one condition it will be u1, it will be zero, means you have to calculate u2, u3 are the unknown displacement. So you have to calculate these two values for the given problem. And for the force vector, so again at the node 1 you will have f1, at the node 2 you will have f2, at the node 3 you will have f3. So the force is applied at node 2, means you have the input value as f2, that is 10 kN. So f2 is equal to 10. What about f1 and f3? That becomes 0. There is no force applied at the 193. So that is the condition. So these two are the boundary condition for the given problem. Okay, when it may be a bar problem, and based on the different structure, you can apply the boundary conditions. Okay, so always remember, fixed is nothing but zero. When there will be displacement, it will be zero. And wherever there is force applied, we have to take that node as a force. Okay, so F2, at node 2, there is a force. So that is 10 kN. So let me take the another example. Second, now we will take the truss element. So in the truss element, you generally find supporters at their ends. So there will be hinge supports, and there may be roller support, Okay, so let us say this is node 1, node 2. And suppose these are the connection. Okay, so whatever may be the structure, but we are concentrating on to get the values of boundary condition, to know the values of boundary condition. Suppose if I apply the load in this direction, so this one as 5 kilonewton. Okay, so now how to find out the boundary condition? As you know, for the truss element there are 2 degree of freedom, means there are 2 displacements. One, it will be horizontal, that is u, and one more, it will be vertical displacement, v. So u, v are the 2 displacement, whereas in the bar you will have only 1 displacement along the axis of the bar. So in case of the truss element you will have 2 displacement. So at the node 1, so I will say u1, v1. So for the node 2, I will say u2, v2. Now, okay, so let us look at the node 1. So at the node 1, there is an hinged support, or there is a fixed support. So here there will be no vertical deformation because of this hinged support. So there will be no vertical deformation. So I can say V1 is equal to 0, that is the first condition. So V1 is equal to 0 for node 1. And similarly, when you look at the node 1, there the force is applied. Okay, the force is applied, but it cannot move in the horizontal directions. The force cannot move in the horizontal because again it is fixed. Okay, it means the U1 is also become 0 because it is an hinge support. Okay, suppose if I remove this one and if I fix to the roller support, now you can say when the force is applied in the horizontal axis, the roller can have some deformation, some displacement in their horizontal axis, but not in the vertical axis. Okay, it may have in the horizontal axis. So there you will have the horizontal deformation that you have to calculate. Now coming to the second one at node 2. Okay, at node 2, again there is no vertical deformation, but it can make in the horizontal deformation because there is an roller supports. It means the U2 is then having some known value, whereas V2 it becomes 0. Means these are the boundary conditions, V1, V2. So vertical, no deformation for the roller or fixed support, any supports. Okay, so that is there. So after that, the force are applied in the horizontal axis. Okay, so it is applied in the horizontal axis towards the right side. So the force F1, because the load is applied at 1, so F1 is equal to, in truss element always we denote with F1x, F1y, next F2x, F2y, again we'll write F3x, F3y. So what it indicates means F1 is the node, x is the horizontal axis. So here the load is applied in the horizontal, means F1 in the horizontal axis. If it is an vertical, suppose if the load is applied like this, it means F1y, the load is will be F1y. So now it is F1x, 5 kilonewton. The F2y, F1y, it will be 0. Okay, so at node 2 there is no, suppose I will apply load like that, another load, I will represent 6 kilonewton. Now I can say the F2y, there is a load at F2y, that is 6 kilonewton. Okay, so like that you have to consider the forces. So using this knowledge you can apply the boundary conditions, okay, in the bar, or it may be beam element or truss element. So thank you for watching.